everyone, welcome to another video here with Exercises for Injuries. My name is Kaya. Today I'm going to take you guys through your top five chair exercises. So we're going to go over five exercises and stretches you can do using a chair that are going to target your those major muscle groups, stretch out some really common tight muscles. You can do it all using a chair, so really good supported versions of some classic exercises and stretches. So first thing we have is a squat. So what we're gonna go through is using the chair and using it to sit to stand back up in, and then sit back down in to work on the muscles that you need for a squat. So you can start by sitting, placing both feet, planting them on the floor, ankles underneath your knees, so your legs are at about a 90 degree angle, core is engaged, and all we're gonna do is practice getting up without using the arms. So if you need to, you can use your arms for support to start with, and then working into just using your legs to stand up. So standing up, and then as you sit down, you're gonna notice you really have to sit your bum back in order to get down to that original starting position, because if you just kind of squat where you are, you're not gonna make it all the way back onto that seat. So you really have to sit your bum back. You can always grab back if you need extra support. So we're working on getting to 10 reps, so 10 repetitions, and working our way up to 3 sets. So maybe for now you can only do 10 and that's it, but eventually getting to the point where you can do 10, take a break, do another 10, take a break, and then do another 10. All right, so the second one's a side lunge. So this is gonna be a nice stretch for the quads and the hip flexors. So we're gonna turn onto one side. So the chair is supporting underneath one of my legs and my other leg is back behind me. I'm turning both hips to face over, straight over my front leg. Okay, so my hips are in line. Both my legs are about 90 degree angles. If you press back into those back toes, you're gonna find it helps to stretch through the front of the thigh and your quads, and then maybe even into your hip flexor. So just a supported way to come into a lunge and a way to get the pressure off your knees if you can't do a lunge on the floor. So we're getting the benefit. We're still working on strengthening. I'm still pushing into my feet. So we're strengthening and stretching without the load that's normally on our joints. And if you want, you can bring one arm up overhead to add in a bit of an opening through the side body. And then you repeat on the other side, holding that for about 30 seconds, and then doing that stretch 2 or 3 times. All right, third one is a lunge. And so all I wanted to talk about with this one is using your chair for support when you do a lunge. So you could also use a wall, but a lot of times, especially with the older clients that I work with, they have a tough time doing a lunge because of the balance aspect. Right, you're in a different stance than you normally are, your center of gravity is different. So a nice thing to do is to either put one hand or both hands on a chair and then do your lunge from here. So you can even use your arms to help push you up, keep you supported, and then you can progress by having one arm down and then maybe one day both arms down. So this front knee is not passing the front toe, and I'm only coming down as long as my knees don't hurt. So maybe you bring your stance in closer together and you do shallower lunges, and that's totally fine as well. All right, number 4, calf raises. So again, using the chair for support, and then if you need to, you can use your arms to help lift you. But we're gonna do calf raises, so coming up on the toes and coming back down. So the chair is just acting as a support, but if you need to, you can lean into the chair or use it to help press you up. And again, a good way to progress, getting to one arm on the chair, and then maybe eventually you don't need the chair. So for both lunges and calf raises, again, we're gonna work up to 10 repetitions. So lunges, 10 repetitions on each side, calf raises, just 10 repetitions because you're doing both feet at once. And again, working up to 3 sets. So you could do this as a circuit. You could go through this, do 10 reps, your 30 second hold, 10 reps, 10 reps, 10 reps, and then trying to get through that 2 to 3 times. All right, lastly is push-ups. So to make this even easier, you can do wall push-ups using the wall. But for a chair, making sure the chair is not gonna go anywhere. So you might actually wanna put the chair against a wall. And then we're walking the feet back and putting the feet together. So the further away my feet are from the chair, the harder it's gonna be. And then of course, depending on how much surface area you have on the chair, it's gonna determine what kind of push-up you do. Wider, hands apart would be more of a classic push-up. If your hands are close together, it'd be more of a tricep push-up where the elbows stay close to the body. So then doing a push-up from here. So all this is doing is the chair is just taking, because I'm on an angle, I have a lot less weight to be lifting than if I was parallel with the floor like a normal push-up. So again, working up to 10 reps and then 2 to 3 times through those reps. So those are your 5 top chair exercises. I hope that you try them out and you enjoy them. If they do, leave us a comment below. Let us know what you think and let us know if you have any questions or things you'd like to see in future videos. So thanks for watching. Make sure to like this video and subscribe to our YouTube channel and check out exercisesforinjuries.com. We'll see you in a future video. Bye.